So basically what we're trying to do is a joint effort between the engineering and the physics department to deploy a mission that is analogous to going into Mars, into the lava tubes in Mars, and looking for life there. So basically what we have an engineering team trying to map out the lava tube caves in the Mojave Desert, so that's where we go. And then we have the physics side where we work in building a spectrometer, so a modular scientific device that goes on the rover and look for life and signs of life on the walls of these lava tubes.
So we have people from the lair working on the navigation, and we have people from the physics department working on instrumentation and recording data. So the physics uses fluorescence and spectrometer data, whereas for navigation we use a particle filter to localize and different methods in order to get the robot to know where it is in the tube, build up a map of where it is, and be able to go down entirely autonomously into an unknown environment.
So a typical field expedition is we wake up at around 6, come out here at 6:30, pack up hard hats, flashlights, headlights, and the Jaguar's chargers, a generator in case we run out of power, 4 laptops or so, leave at 7 o'clock, get there by 9, and then we have to do some off-road vehicle driving, which is always kind of a bumpy fun ride. Go down to the tubes, which is about maybe a half mile walk with all our, you know, we got a lot of things to carry, the Jaguars can be a little heavy. And once we're there, which is maybe at 10 o'clock, we've already started collecting data, eat lunch and get out of there by 3, hopefully, usually.
So we're out here today at the lava tubes in the Mojave Desert to test out some equipment. So this is a fluorescence spectrometer that we built specially for this mission. And basically what we want to do is map out the lava tubes using some robots and then use the spectrometer to gather data from the walls and look for interesting things that fluoresce in the wall. And this is supposed to serve as an analogous mission on looking for life in lava tubes in Mars.
I think this is what real life is like it's collaborative, it's interdisciplinary, and you have a project which has a lot of different aspects and you have to work with a lot of different people, which is kind of what our project is like there's a physics side of it, and even in exploration and robotics side of it, there are like different parts. Sean is working on exploring it, Sam is working on mapping the tubes, and then I'm working on having different robots do different things. So we have to keep track of a lot of things, and I feel like in real projects that's how it goes, and it will definitely help me whatever I decide to do after this.
I'm an engineer, and I'm not sure what kind of engineer I would want to be, and this project made me sure that I want to do some kind of research with images and computer vision.
This opportunity is unique to Harvey Mudd in that we have undergraduates working on graduate level research projects. So it's not something that undergrad students or even maybe grad students at different universities or colleges have access to. This is one reason why I chose Harvey Mudd, to have these opportunities, to have these points where we could access and work with professors on really in-depth and valuable projects that have real-world applications.